Captain JJ back on the mic. This time around, it's Master Cup episode GX of Master Class episode GX. And this time around, I'm going to be doing with a completely different machine. I'm going to be trying to do it in numerical order when possible. So Red Gazelle is first up. It's not the best machine though. Well, it does have a weak body, strong boost, and its grip is a little bit on the icky side. It's neither here or there. All the easier tracks are first up, so let's kick into a utility twist to it. Maybe it's a simpler track on the whole. I haven't played this machine in such a long time, so it might take a bit of time getting used to it. Stop me from destroying the machine though. Speed wise, it's the same. It's around about the same as the blue bar. That is so weird. Really use the meta rail side just to make sure it got to the end as the winner. I don't know why, but it felt weird. The machine felt a bit weird because the rainbow finished into account. In comparison to how I was playing the Blue Falcon earlier in the evening, it felt strange. Anyway, it's Casino Palace Splitto next up. Bit of a struggle for me considering how weak my body is. Yeah, but this handling is not. Yeah, but this handling needs a lot to be desired. This duration is a little bit different. And the rail time is getting a lot better now. Oh, it's very good. It's going to turn third. Yeah, then we're not to finish this time as Magic Seagull. We're finishing in the top 15 as a result of its third place. Third Poseidon's next up. Now, because of that, this may well be a slight circuit. This could be a bit of a nightmare. I don't know if the circuit side. Jump at the beginning, those are long sweeping corners. Wait, attempt to find out. Three, two, one, go! big. This Titan, as it does handle reasonably well. It's able to get around tight corners reasonably, but the thing about here is that it loses speed when I slide. The equipment level though is a little bit more difficult to manage than it is to move down. I don't think the boost that strong for Mighty Gazelle, and that was a bit of a problem. And that was not what I had in mind at all. That was a complete nutcracker of a move there. Trying to move the turbo side, it didn't work. I was able to get away with it this time though, but I can't really afford to hit anything else at this point. Not if I wanted to stay alive. Okay, I can get away with that. Black Shadow. Just gonna stay ahead. Loop cross now. Loopy loops. Slide loops. Up and down loop. Back to back loops. You name it. And also wars, if I hit, is a disaster. Just get it to the flag. let's jump into this final race of the Rubik's Cup. Oh shoot! Messed that one up. The one time I went for the jump, I messed it up. Taking things a little bit too quickly there myself. Fish, bam, wallop. I don't miss that. I can't afford to hit anything here. Well, at least I'm still in the running, unlike last time where I ended up flying off the track. Oh, of course, and that's the Rubik's Cup. Favorite thing, that's the only one to fall off. Again, cooking, see the Rubik's. A bit of AI fail there for my Gazelle. but it's on for the race, so it's fine. Maximum score in this round. Next machine on this cut will be the White Cat. So, until then, this is Captain JJ, checking out.